Welcome to NMO for Lost Marbles. As you can see, it's got leaderboards. If you buy it, it's on green light, which I'll link. Marble skins, which apparently you can look at in the demo. Options. Music slider, volume slider for both in the game and the menu. I love you. I love you so much. Video. There are an ass load of resolution options up to 16AA. They're all MSAA as far as I know. Full screen, vertical sync, etc. Controls. It just gives you these. But I don't. I'm going to assume there's no actual controls, but we'll see. This is a game for Windows and Mac by Binary. My note says Takeover. Takeover. I'm pretty sure it's Takeover. Binary Takeover. For $10. Learn the basics of the game as well as the marble strengths and weaknesses. Okay. Let's get a feel for each one by itself. Move with WASD or left stick. Okay, so there are controls. So, okay, you can move. I'll move based on the way the camera faces, which is right. And there goes Steam. That's okay. Oh Jesus! And now I can make my marble turn. Bam, bam. Okay, next level. This is using the mouse, but it doesn't appear to be working. What if I try using the keyboard? No, that also doesn't work. Let's go to new level. Okay, so next level thing doesn't seem to work. Oh! Wait, what? This marble is made of rubber and can jump. I mean, the controls are basically what I would use, but still. Always nice to have that option. Will next level work this time? No, it will not. Okay. Funnily enough, you have to use the scroll wheel here, as far as I can tell. Oh, there's different chapters. Okay, I see. The little guy. This marble's made of paper. It moves fastest, but is vulnerable to every hazard. Puts the agile in fragile. Paper's ability allows it to shrink. Oh, well that's interesting. I don't understand why you would ever be big, though. Do I move slower? It doesn't feel like it. Okay, that must be a checkpoint. Does the timer reset? No. Okay. Oops, I'm an idiot. I'm a dummy. Oh, those are spikes. I'm dumb. Oh my god. Okay. I figured it out. Nope. I was too slow on that. Oh, no. I didn't figure it out. The first one's on this side. And it didn't undo it fast enough. I always forget I need to start on this side, so I instinctively move to where I need to. I was too slow again. I actually forgot to do it that time. Too slow to move my mouse. Ow, dicks. This music. I feel like I've done a game like this before. And I don't honestly remember. Okay, we're gonna take our time so we can try some other stuff. Oh shit! But I seem to remember that one being less sort of obstacle base. Oh, okay. But this is kind of interesting. I don't know, it's really weird. You can use your mouse, but it also gives you options for a controller, which I did not get keys to be bound. It's a Unity game, so I'm surprised it didn't give me a launcher like it usually does, like they usually do, rather. But there are leaderboards and stuff. Ball of steel. Heavy and slow, but immune to everything. Oh, I didn't read the ability. It's a speed boost. Okay. And then I can break stuff with it. Okay, that's interesting. Trapdoors will collapse shortly after you roll over them. Okay. So there's lots of obstacles and stuff that you deal with differently depending on the ball. Oh, that's interesting. Okay. Okay, that's cool. I kind of get the idea of this game. It's basically an obstacle course a la Marble Madness. Oh, dicks. Without enemies and more, like, actual obstacles. And each ball has its own ability. New level. That's kind of cool. The music's kind of meh. I mean, it's not interesting. It's not bad, it's just not interesting to me. But that's always personal preference. I wonder if you can get more than these three. Let's see, how many chapters do we have here? We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 levels, and it only shows 3 chapters. I have to hope if they're charging $10 for this that there's more than that. Oh god. QE to swap marbles. Okay, this just got infinitely more interesting. So I'm gonna have to stand here. Oh god, this is like Marble Madness crossed with Lost Vikings. Crossed with... Huh. This is interesting. I don't understand. Ooh, yes I do. Paper will blow. Oops. Oh god, I know exactly what I'm gonna have to do. Oh no. This game just got itself way harder. I'm gonna stand right here. Switch. I'm gonna switch here. Drop it. Now we're gonna switch. Shrink. Hit the switch. Okay, I have to stay on it. But since I'm immune, I can roll all the spikes. HUD in the bottom left. Oh, interesting. Oh, okay, I see what I have to do. Gotta go across here. And then stop on here. Wait, what? Oh, because I'm smaller, I guess? Oh no, it's higher than I am, I see. Oh, come on. Up the stairs you go. Up the stairs you- Okay, what was this? If you were light enough. Might be able to avoid tripping trapdoors if you were light enough. But couldn't I just... Oh, Jesus. Oh, I fucked myself. I see. But I actually want to trip this door. But that'll leave me... Okay, I see. No, I don't see. I lied.
damage.
Okay. It controls well, though. Am I supposed to use the box? It definitely has frame rate issues. I don't know what that's about. Now if I shrink and then go large, is that enough to activate this trapdoor with the box on it? No. Wow. Okay, I'm actually confused on what I'm supposed to do now then. This is interesting. Whatever, I can run through here. Let's see what's up here. I don't know what this did. I have no idea what this is doing. Oh, it's making that platform raise. This is interesting. Oh god, is that really what I have to do? That's amazing. This game's kind of fun, kind of definitely an interesting idea of having to control more than two. I don't think I've played a marbles game, and I look for these games. I love this sort of thing. But I don't think I've ever seen one that does it quite like this. Oh, dicks. So that's really interesting to me. But I feel like I'm doing this right. Get this guy up here. Switch. I have to roll across this like fucking mad. No, I don't understand. I guess I don't understand. Because it doesn't look like I can land on this, right? No, I guess I can. That switches it. But then how do I get from down there to up? This is interesting. Oh, you got zoom abilities too. Okay. Oh, I see. I get it. I get it. And then move across. And then go through. Okay, I'm a dummy. This is interesting though. Now see, that looks dangerous to me, but if I get on here, and switch... No! Okay, I see. I go through here. No, okay, I can't go through that. Never mind then. Oh, damn it. Took too long. Okay, it's still on the switch though. This one's taking me a long-ass time. This is an interesting game. I will say, I have noticed my mouse being on the other monitor, so care for that if you've got multi-monitor stuff. Oh, okay, the weight crushes it. Now see, this game is just so interesting. That's cool. Now I bring that one up. Because now this is unblocked, so I can just come up here like that. Okay, that's cool. I kind of dig this. We're going to go back to new level. Let's see what else we've got here. Let's go back. Play game options. So there's marble skins. Leaderboard. I don't know if these are the only three marbles. And if these are the only 20 levels, normal and... Ooh, I wonder what hardcore is. I'm gonna guess hardcore is once you do it, you're done. Three. Now see, what I'm wondering is if this is really the end of it. Just these three. I'm not exactly sure I would pay $10 for... What is it, 30 levels? And you do get to a point where you have to use all three. That's actually interesting, too. I'm gonna quit back to the menu. I wish I knew that for sure. But it kind of makes me doubt it. So for me personally, I don't know if the $10 is worth it, but this is definitely an interesting game. I never would have thought of a Marbles game with the Lost Vikings sort of switch controls of what you're doing and to progress sort of thing. That's really interesting. Music's meh, graphics are meh, but you know, it's a fucking marble game. I actually don't expect much in terms of graphics. No control options to change your controls, but whatever. Like literally it's movement keys and jump. I guess it works with a controller because it gives you these buttons, so I guess it works with the 360 controller, which I do not have because I don't like the 360 controller. But interesting. I would like to see the Unity launcher. Maybe it did happen, I just didn't see it glitch through automatically. So I could change the controls. Especially for a controller. Like, if it reads it, but the buttons are different, I'd like to be able to fix that without having to use X360 CE or anything else like that, because that's always kind of obnoxious to do. But it doesn't recognize my controller either, which is a little strange. Usually I'll get it recognized, but it won't be the right buttons. But check it out. I do like that it has a hold mouse to move. That's interesting as well. That's useful. Again, it does not seem to hold your mouse. So be careful if you are using the hold mouse that you're not on another monitor or something if you have that issue. But check it out at least. $10. Demo's free. I'll link all everywhere into the descriptions. Thanks for watching.